Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making steak and beer cheese nachos. Now we went on a field trip recently, and one of the items that we had was our appetizer, which happened to be steak and beer cheese nachos. And I did have a couple of requests, one special request for it, and I'm trying to work it into my schedule. So it's been a while since we actually did that trip, but I want to make that for you. We need to make some things on the side before we put it all together, and one thing is to make beer cheese. I have a couple of recipes for beer cheese in Betty's Kitchen. There's one that's called Betty's Beer Cheese, and there's one that's Betty's version of Hall's Snappy Beer Cheese. Around here, the famous beer cheese was invented at Hall's restaurant, and it's called Hall's Snappy Beer Cheese. So I'm going to give you a variety of that. I can't say it's their exact recipe, but it's close. So I'm just going to do this quickly. If you want more instructions about it, you can go to that recipe in Betty's Kitchen. But to the side here, we're making our beer cheese. 2 cups of sharp cheese. Now, you need to have it shredded and ready to go in a blender or food processor. To that, we're adding 1/4 teaspoon of garlic powder. Next comes 1/4 teaspoon of ground red pepper. Makes it nice and spicy. And then we have some more spice here, Tabasco sauce or some hot sauce that you might want. 1/4 teaspoon. Usually you just shake out a few drops there, but I measure this to be 1/4 teaspoon. Then I'm going to put the lid on, and this is going to be blended, and I'll watch the consistency and stop it at some point, and then I'll add the beer in with it. So I'm just going to pulse for a while and look at it. When your cheese mixture comes together about like this, it's time to add the beer. Now this is supposed to be stale beer or flat beer. What you can do is open it the night before, pour out the amount you need, and just let it sit like this, uncovered. So we have 1/4 cup of stale beer. I'm sure it would be fine if you used fresh beer. Put the lid on and then blend again. This is the kind of consistency I'm getting, and it's actually just perfect for beer cheese. Beer cheese is generally served with celery and saltine crackers and maybe some carrot strips. So this is just perfect for that. But when I remember the nachos that we had at the restaurant, I know that the beer cheese was fairly liquid and it had been poured over the top. So what I'm going to do is make this thinner. And you can always do this yourself for your purpose. If you want it a little bit thinner, add some more beer. If you don't have an extra beer, then you can add milk. Just add a little bit and see what this does. I'm not even giving a measure on this. I have my beer cheese in a little bowl, and you can see the consistency that I have made it. You might want it a little runnier than that. You can see that I added a little bit of extra beer. If you want this a little more liquid, then just add more beer. But I'm going to cover this and set it aside while I work on my steak. Right here I have a steak which is top sirloin, and it is approximately 1 pound. It's a little bit under 1 pound. It's very thick, and I remember the nachos we had little cubes of steak, so I decided that this needed to be sliced into 2 halves. And you can see I've already done that. It's easiest to slice if you freeze it first, and then I had mine frozen for a couple of days, and then I put it in the refrigerator overnight, and then I got it out on the counter so that when I sliced it, there were still some ice crystals in it. But it has had a chance to sit at room temperature for a while, so I don't think there are any ice crystals now. I'm going to salt the inner part because I've already done the outside. And I'm just using sea salt, coarse sea salt here, and then also some peppercorns. Just grind those over the top. And while I'm doing this, I have been heating an iron skillet. So it's beginning to smoke. I know it must be ready. So I'm going to use tongs and lift this over, and it should sizzle. And that will seal the bottom. I'll let it cook for a while on that side. And I'm going to get both of these. We only need one probably for this recipe. But since I'm going to the trouble of cooking one, I might as well cook two. And I can use the other one for a different purpose, maybe a steak sandwich or something like that. Here we have our two steaks, and I decided to check them with the thermometer. For medium well, the reading should be from 150 to 155. So I think we're there. What we're going to do is bring this off the stove and put it on a cutting board and then tent it with aluminum foil and let it rest just for 5 minutes or so. I've had my steak resting about 5 minutes, so I'm going to take the aluminum foil off the top, cut against the grain. That looks nice. And then I'll just make this into little cubes. I'm ready to assemble my nachos. So I've got a large dish. I'm going to make enough here for everybody around here to eat. And I'm going to put blue corn chips in. I'm not using any of the regular corn chips. They're all blue. Now, I think the meat should go on next. It doesn't really matter. But some of these things I'm going to heat in the oven, and others I'm going to put fresh on the top. So here is the meat that I have prepared. And we'll take the little cubes and sprinkle them over the corn chips, trying to get pretty good coverage throughout. And this is much meatier than what we had at the restaurant, but it's a much deeper dish too. So it will be fairly compact with food. I think that's probably enough though. Next comes the beer cheese. So we have our beer cheese. It's kind of spreadable. It's not pourable that much, but I think we can make do. Now on top of this, I'm putting a 5-cheese blend. Actually, what I have shredded here is a 4-cheese Mexican blend, but I put in some queso fresco. So I'm calling this my 5-cheese blend. I think all of this needs to go in the oven and get warmed up, melted, and nice and hot before we put the toppings on. I didn't have any specific measures on any of these dishes that I've put out here. So to a 350 degree oven or 375 or 400 until it looks nice and bubbly, then we'll get it back out. The nachos are out of the oven. They had about 10 minutes at 375 degrees, and you can see that the cheese is melted, and some of these are really hot, and then I put some fresh ones around the edge just because I felt like it needed more of the blue tortilla chips. Now we put the toppings on. So we have cilantro, so you want to have chopped cilantro that you'll put everywhere in whatever depth you want. I just put all of what I had out here. I didn't measure it. And then we have green onions or scallions that you will slice the tops of. And you can also use the white part too. I just happened to get the green part only. And I'm not putting all of those in. I don't think there need to be as many of those. Then I have a couple of jalapeno peppers that we got from our garden. I'm not going to put too many because that can really be overpowering. And then I'm going to take some lime and squeeze that over the top of all of it. And then put a few lime wedges here and there. And that's it. So I'll be taking a taste in just a minute. I'm going to serve some of these onto a plate. So I'm going here to the edge and going under so that I get all of the layers. And I have a very wide spatula. So that gets a lot of it. And I'll just bring it out like that. And steal one of those lime wedges. And that's my plate. So where to begin? I guess I will go to this part that has everything. Seems to be a little bit of everything, and I'm not going to take it all in my mouth, but I'm going to take a nice bite of this. Got some meat. It tastes really good. The cilantro and those cheeses are wonderful. I think it's just great. I'm glad we ordered it at the restaurant, and I'm glad that some of you requested that I make it, because I probably would have just thought, well, maybe I'll order that again sometime. But now I think it's going to be kind of a regular around our house because it tastes so good. It's really interesting and different from all of my other nachos, which I have many in Betty's kitchen. So I hope you enjoy it.